For our second hot copy, some inspiring news this morning. The Philippines now has 37 gold medals in the SEA Games. Manila is at the third spot in the medal tally, next to Thailand and Vietnam. And with us this morning is, I would have to say, a first-time competitor for the SEA Games. She represented the Philippines. This is her first representation. Aliyah Finnegan, she turned heads at the Games. She grabbed a total of 4 medals in the 31st Southeast Asian Games for the Philippines, among them gold finishes in the gymnastics vault and team event. She has 2 golds, 2 silvers. Good morning to you, Aliyah.
Good morning.
My God, congratulations. I would have to say, what's amazing with your story is this is your first run, actually. The first time you're in the Games.
Yes, absolutely. I was really excited coming in. You know, it was my first time. I've had a few international competitions in the past, but this was indeed my first SEA Games.
Yeah, you are Filipino-American. Let's give a little history about you. I mean, tell us about yourself. We've heard from all the other athletes, you know, but what about you? Have you always lived in Manila? Did you study here? What's your story?
So I was born and raised in America. However, my mom was born and raised here in Manila. And then whenever she was about 19, 20, she moved over to the States for university. And so we still have lots of family here in Manila and in the Philippines. And I'm actually here right now and I'm really excited to be here.
Now, you represented the Philippines. Would you consider yourself, I mean, it's quite interesting, Filipino, you know, I mean, clearly you are Filipino, but one wouldn't identify you as Filipino immediately when seeing you.
Yes, I have had that case happen before. You know, sometimes I'll tell people and they won't believe me at first. And I'm like, yes, I am actually. And I'm really just proud to be able to represent the Philippines.
Yes. When were you invited to represent the Philippines?
So it first came up in conversation around last September-ish, and you know, it was really kind of up in the air. I wasn't really sure if it was something that I wanted to, you know, take a part of.
You've never competed. I mean, you've never competed in any regional competition, or even to represent any country in the past.
I represented the States in the past.
Okay.
Yes,
you did. Yes. All right. Okay, go on.
So, my first time representing the Philippines, you know, it was lots of discussion, lots of kind of, you know, what ifs. I wasn't really sure exactly what I wanted to do. But then last March, I want to say, I was able to, you know, kind of put my foot down and be like, this is what I want to do.
What made you want to represent the Philippines, considering you represented the United States previously?
I think it was more so just like the amount of support that I had gotten from the Philippines, and along with my mom and her having her ties here, and I really just wanted to make her and then make the rest of my family proud.
All right, now let's talk about your training. I mean, having 2 golds, what an entrance, right? I mean, your maiden performance with the SEA Games. Let's talk about that. How did you train? Why do you think did you get the gold?
I had been training in the States, you know, before coming here. I am still a college athlete, and so I was training at my university in Louisiana there, and then I was able to take one of my college coaches with me to the SEA Games, and so it was lots of stressful kind of training. I still had to balance, you know, my studies as well. However, I was able to kind of manage all of that and be able to be here.
Yeah. Okay. So 2 golds, 2 silvers. What's next for you? What was, you know, before you answer that, what was most difficult, I guess, with a vault?
I think the most difficult, like training wise or in the actual competition?
In the actual competition.
It was probably just because it all happened so quick. You know, you have your warm-up time and then you just go over to the competition arena and then it just happened so fast. We had a little malfunction with the boards there, kind of wasn't really sure what was going on before I started. And then when I started, you know, it's very loud in the arena. There's lots of noise going on. There's lots of just movement going around. So sometimes it can be a little hard to stay focused, but I'm glad I was able to really lock in and nail my vaults.
Okay. When you were rehearsing, when you were training rather, was there something that you specifically had to overcome that you believe made you grab the gold?
I actually did have a little bit of a rough time in warm up with my vaults. You know, I wasn't really hitting them the way that I wanted to. I knew I was capable of doing it. However, you know, the warm ups, they weren't there. But you know, whenever you go into the arena, you really have to just settle in with yourself and you have to focus. And I think I did that.
Yeah. I'm curious, did you and Carlos Yula share notes?
No, we didn't actually. I wish I did though. Maybe he's got some good tips for me. I was really so honored to meet him. You know, I watched him go through the 2019 World Championships, and then I was just kind of following along on his journey throughout gymnastics. And it was really so cool to just be competing with him.
Yeah. Now, did you always want to be a gymnast?
I started when I was 2 years old, so it was more just kind of, I just grew up with it. It was something that, you know, I fell in love with at a young age and I just stuck with it.
Yeah, you stuck with it. And now, I would have to say now, your goal is the Olympics part of it. Is that part of the dream?
Not necessarily. I'm really just trying to take it one day at a time. I don't have any future plans with further competition in the moment. Obviously, you know, that door is not completely closed, but for now I'm just taking it one day at a time, really focusing on resting my body, and then we'll just see where it goes from there.
Okay. You talked about the support that was offered to you, which is one of the reasons you were encouraged to represent the Philippines, but I'm sure you've seen what athletes go to up close. I mean, our local athletes, you have a comparison when you also represented the U.S. What do you believe, what do our athletes need? What would you want to see in the coming years? Because we've had such a good showing in this year's SEA Games.
Right, absolutely. I'm really just so amazed and how, you know, talented and hardworking all of these athletes are. I mean, they just wake up every day and it's like that drive that they have inside of them. And it was really cool to be able to watch. It was different. There was just something special about them.
Yes. But what would you want to see? What kind of support do you believe? Because we do have an incoming administration, a new administration coming in to further improve our athletes.
Right. I definitely think the gym that these girls train at, I definitely think there could be an upgrade there. You know, these girls train in constant, you know, heat, and it's really impressive what they're able to do, you know, with what they have. And I would really like to see some improvements in that area.
Yeah. Okay. That's one. Would you go back to the US? I mean, soon, or are you staying in Manila?
Yes, I will be in Manila until Sunday, and then I'll head back to the States.
Okay. And when you go back to the States, I'm curious, what happens after? I mean, this is where you represented the Philippines, but then you go back to the States, you train there. And then do you ever come back? Will you partly live here, train here? How does it work for you, given that you represented the country?
Right. So you don't have to necessarily train in the country that you are representing. You know, Carlos is training in Japan while representing the Philippines. And so I will just be training in the States. However, now I get to take a break and I'm able to, you know, kind of travel a little bit. I'll be working a lot and really just focusing on resting myself.
All right. You're 19 years old. I'm curious, are you still in college?
I am, yes. I just finished my first year at Louisiana State University, and I'll head back there in a few months to continue my second year.
All right. Do you know any Filipino Tagalog words? Not very much. She must be there. What did she say?
I'm sorry?
I mean, your mother, Mimi, I can imagine she must be so proud beyond words,
absolutely.
Right?
Yes.
I mean, you come back to the Philippines, represent her country.
Yes, I mean, it was like my first thought after getting off the podium. You know, we received our medals, we received our flowers, you know, that cute little stuffed toy that they gave us. But like my first immediate thing was, I have to go find my mom, you know. And so afterwards, I ran up to her off the podium. And so I handed her flowers. And it was really just such a special moment between us.
Oh, I can see it. You're still emotional about it, of course. I'm curious, have you learned any Tagalog words?
I'm learning now. It's still very very new, but I'm constantly like hearing it. Obviously, you know, my mom speaks it and found it a lot. So hopefully maybe my next time I'll be able to have a little bit more.
Were you able to travel? I mean, you're in Manila now, right, Alea?
Yes,
in Manila. Were you able to travel out of Manila before you go back to the US? Are you able to do that?
We went to Tagaytay yesterday and we were able to kind of see some of just some of the beautiful different places. You know, we got to try some different foods there. And then we're really just kind of, you know, relaxing here, you know, visiting some places that I hadn't been able to see before we head back on Sunday.
Well, you know what? Congratulations to you. Two golds, two silvers on your first try. I mean, seriously, that's something that not just will inspire you, but you'll carry it with you all your life. And I do hope that you get to know the Philippines more, Alea.
Yes. Salamat po.
Salamat po. All right. Mag-ingat ka. Mag-ingat ka. Okay. All right. You take care. Thank you very much. And congratulations once again.
Thank you.